In this video, I'm going to try to convince you to use contiguous datasets. Often I see non-contiguous datasets. I was just doing a training this morning with a foundation and they had non-contiguous datasets. They had data for this country over here and this country over here times a dozen different countries, which meant they were doing a dozen different sets of formulas and pivot tables and charts and reporting. So what I was trying to convince them of, and I'm trying to convince you too of this, is to keep all of your data in one central hub, one central location, a contiguous touching data set, so that you do one set of formulas, pivot tables, charts, dashboards, reports. And then later, when you're at the slicing and dicing stage, you slice and dice by this country and this country. I'm a visual person, as you might have guessed, so in this video, I'm going to show you what that could look like. I'm Anne Emery. You're watching Dataviz on the Go, the series where you learn Dataviz time savers inside everyday software like good old Excel. Okay, this is what a contiguous data set would look like for a fictional grantmaker. This is nobody's real data, but this is based on many, many foundations that I've worked with over the years. So we've got fictional grantee names, we've got fictional grant or project names, we've got fictional staff members who manage these grants like Anne Emery and Frank Funder, and who else did I create here? Gwen Grantmaker is here. Now, before the foundation that I was working with this morning, these aren't their real country names, but they had a spreadsheet for El Salvador, and then they had a spreadsheet for Chile, and it seems really simple, right? It seems really straightforward. Like, yeah, we'd want to look at just El Salvador's grants. So we'd want to look at just Chile's grants. So they kept them in separate locations. Pretty intuitive, right? Keep the data separate so you can analyze and think about it separately. And here I am being like, not quite. Let's do the counterintuitive thing of combining it all into a contiguous data set. So hence the point of this video. I want to show you how that can help. Let's say you want to do some basic data cleaning and recoding. Maybe you want to look at, let's say, the difference between how much money the grantee requested and how much money you ended up giving them. Now, this is really simple math. That's just basic elementary school subtraction. This number minus this number. It doesn't take all day to do that, but when you're doing little calculations like that, dozens of them for El Salvador and for Chile and for Zambia and for all the different places that you need to slice and dice by, those seconds and minutes can really add up. And I'm a fan of working smart, not hard, as I'm sure you are too. So I'm trying to give you your seconds and your minutes back. Here's another example. Let's say they needed to do some basic recoding of taking all these different statuses. What are the different categories we have? The grant was completed, or pending, or proposed. And maybe you just want to look at completed versus not completed. Now, this is a really basic if statement, but again, in real life, your spreadsheet's going to have tons more columns, tons more rows. I want to give you your seconds and minutes back. So if you keep everything together, you only have to do that formula one time, and then you forget about it, and you move on to the next thing on your to-do list. Then you can do one set of pivot tables, looking at things like funding per grantee. What else do we have in here? Funding by geography, funding by year, one set of pivot tables. Later, you make one set of charts, like a bar chart showing funding per grantee or a column chart showing funding by geography. And at the very end, at the slicer stage, that's where you slice and dice and you make it not contiguous anymore. That's where you keep Chile's data and El Salvador's data like this. You just use the slicers to say, let me just look at Chile and just report on that. Actually, here's Chile right here. Here it is. Like this one. Okay, here's just Chile's data and here's just El Salvador's data. Or you could look at just Anne's grants that I pretend to manage, or just Frank Funder's grants, and so on. Keep the data in one data set. So you do one set of formulas, one set of pivot tables, one set of charts, one template, and that's when you slice and dice. At the very end, at the very end is with the slicers to get your time back. So you can go do other things on your to-do list and stop working late and stop working weekends and go do other stuff outside of Excel.
And speaking of doing things other than Excel, here's one of my babies. Hi, Sloan. Hi, good walking. Oopsie.